High School. They all walk out because the school allowed a teacher who used the N-word multiple times to come back with virtually no penalty whatsoever. This was in Decatur, Georgia. Students walked out of class in protest after the teacher used the N-word and was allowed to simply act as if nothing happened. Here's some of the video. Decatur, Georgia is in the metro area of Atlanta where I'm at. And in full disclosure, I received a request from, let's say, a friend of the school system. And that request was, would you be willing to meet with the administration? My answer stands. No, not until the teacher's fired. Now, once the teacher is fired, once there's a disciplinary process, I will. But I stand with the students. And the students are not receiving the justice they deserve. So until that happens, I will simply criticize the school, the teacher, and the principal. That's it. That's what you will get from me. It needs to happen this week. Let me give you the background to this. And those students are the ones acting like the adults. Put up the picture of the school. I'm going to tell you the principal and everything else. Principal Rochelle Lofstrand failed to be a leader. Last Friday, hundreds of students walked out of Decatur High School after the teacher used the N-word and there was no penalty. Based on what we can gather from the LinkedIn profile, Facebook, and the school's teacher directory, Mr. John Chestnut is a physics teacher at Decatur High School. It all began when two students were heard using the N-word in class, according to the narrative. Mr. Chestnut tried but failed to correct them when he chose to use the N-word himself a bunch of times. Students said he kept saying it over and over again, ultimately defeating the entire purpose of whatever lesson he attempted to make. His use of the word made a lasting impact on the students, so they held a rally in protest of this behavior. Let me put some context here, because every time I do a story like this, there's a group of people that will say, well, but the kids are saying it. Okay, let's assume that's true, which we don't have it confirmed, no video of it, but let's assume it's true. Students say a lot of things. Students drop the F-bomb. Students say the B-word. Did the teacher do that? Do teachers, do educators utilize the same profanity that immature students use? No, because they are hired as what? Professionals. So if you're a professional, the obligation is upon you to be professional, regardless of unprofessionalism by others. There's more. Mika Wolf, co-president of the Black Student Union, had this to say, and I quote, people were appalled in the class. Everybody was shocked. This is not something acceptable for a teacher to say. They asked him what he has said. You know, what he did, he repeated it twice more. He said the N-word. One time was a possibility of it being a mistake. I mean, the black students are literally trying to give this guy the benefit of the doubt. But two more times, being three times in total, that is not a mistake. After that, he sat down at his desk and he said, I can say whatever I want. Put up the superintendent. Buck stops with the superintendent. Her name is Maggie Furman. Ms. Furman said, and I quote, as a white woman, you don't say, Ms. Furman, as a white woman and an anti-racist, I believe racial slurs and symbols of oppression are never acceptable in any context. As the superintendent for CSD, I am committed to addressing and interrupting racism where and when I see it. Well, let me help you out here, superintendent. You see how your statement created a generalization of racism when it is a specific example before you? Start there. Interrupt that kind of racism. It's called implicit bias. You decided to address racism in general rather than the specific issue happening at that institution or the specific person who did it. There's more. As I have learned more about the situations, it is clear that both of these were harmful to students, members of our community, and to CSD staff members. I want to ensure our students, staff, and community that there are several layers to our approach in addressing these situations as work is done to repair the harm committed. Damn it, it's not complicated. Fire the man. Tell the students you stand with them and love them. Show through example who you actually say you are. It's not complicated at all. These children should not have to walk out of class to get your attention because there's a teacher saying the N-word to them. Students are not always listening. I've been a high school teacher myself, but they are always learning. They are always learning. What do you think you're teaching them by this kind of action? Decatur High School principal Rochelle Lofstren sent out a letter. Sent out a letter to parents detailing the incident and expressing that any form of discrimination is not acceptable. Once again, generalization. The letter in part reads like the letters we've seen one too many times in cases like this. Mr. Chestnut was removed from class for only one day and in part had this to say when he came back. It was harmful for me to say. For me to say it, for me as a middle-aged white man to say it, it hits a different way. And it's almost like it's cool. And it's definitely not. And I could have thought about that in the moment and done something different. I had the opportunity, there's more. I had the opportunity to think about how and why that got past the filter. Right, it's easy for me to wonder growing up in this country at the time I did, starting in the past when I have absorbed some racist nonsense that's still plumping around in my brain. Sir, you need to figure your life out before you start teaching children. You all over the damn place. This is supposed to be a coordinated written response, and even in this, it's silly as hell. There's more. Students claim the teacher was not sincere and are demanding more to be done. Mika Wolf said, that's the leader, the young leader at the institution, at the school, said, and I quote, we do not want a precedent to be set. Listen to how erudite these students are. They're concerned about precedent. We do not want a precedent to be set that derogatory abuses may be used freely in the classroom. So we demand that the teacher be at least suspended, if not expelled. Why? They would have did that to the student. Okay, why not? If he is to return to our school, we demand that he receive bias training, discrimination training, to understand why and what he did was wrong. Because clearly by saying, I can say whatever I want, he does not understand the power that the word holds against his black students. And he also does not understand, dear sister, the position of trust he's in at that school. All right, we're going to stay on top of it. Once again, I stand with the students 100%. Ben, thoughts here?
Well, what a magnanimous, noble statement from the students to be able to see it so clearly and to even show the possibility of mercy and say, if he's not fired, we at least demand a long suspension and then bias training. These are the future, thank God, of our country that will be able to create a more just world. But you can see the bias even in the statement of anti-bias. You can see it in the statement from the superintendent. Because what does she say? I'm committed to interrupting racism.
Right.
What's an interruption? It's just, let me just quickly pause it. Then you can go ahead and continue one more time. How about stopping it? How about being committed to stopping racism? I'm just gonna give it a little pause, a one-day suspension, then go ahead and say what you will. There is just a continual pattern of sticking up for and defending the power positions, the people in power, and not the people who are supposed to be served by those in power. And that proves you do not understand. You have a fundamental misunderstanding of what power positions are supposed to do. They are supposed to be there to serve those that they are granted the trust of power over. And when they abuse that trust, it's done. That's if the apology, if the correction is not to the satisfaction of the aggrieved parties, they need to be let go because that is the consequence. This man teaches physics, that's a physics reaction right there. You do something that offends people, there is an equal and opposite reaction.
Response.
You're gone.
That's right. The energy transfers.